Come, Mr. Tallyman, tally me banana.
Daylight come and me want go home.
Day-o, day-o.
Lainey Kazan, and you're watching barryz.
Hi, it's barryz from the barryz Show, live from the Metropolitan Room, talking to the Broadway legend herself, Tammy Grimmes, who performed here tonight.
Thank you, barryz.
What a show. And you and I use the same hairdresser, John D'Arazio.
That's true.
Thank you.
That's true.
We'll be right back after these messages.
Love you.
Hi, it's barryz from the barryz Show at the Metropolitan Room, or should say the Met, talking to Joel Vig. Tell us your involvement with Tammy Grimmes, the show.
Well, actually, I had the great pleasure of directing Tammy Grimmes in this evening. And earlier this last year, Tammy Grimmes and I were at the Tennessee Williams Festival, and I directed a stage reading of a play called The Strangest Kind of Romance. And at that time, I said to her, Tammy, you know, you really have to put together a nightclub act and come back to the cabaret stage. And she said, you know, I think you may be right. I think I'll think about it.
Oh, that is such good news. Oh, I can't tell you what news that is to me.
We started talking about it, and we started putting things together, and we just, this is our third night, and they just asked us to extend one more night. We're coming back a week from tonight on Thursday, the 19th of April at 8 p.m. And
bring this to Broadway where it belongs.
Oh, I think that sounds great. If Elaine Stritch can do it, Tammy Grimmes can do it.
Tell me about the show and the songs.
Well, you know, we sort of started putting together different pieces because I had been on a ship with the Theater Guild, and Tammy did a show a few years ago while we sailed up the Amazon. And her musical director, who was her husband, Richard Bell, was a wonderful, eclectic. He played classical music and pop and rock and roll, and he played for Janis Joplin and Judy Collins. And so he had this wide range of songs that Tammy sang, and several of them are in this evening tonight. But the one thing I said to Tammy is, you really have to, for your fans' sake, do some of the numbers you introduced in New York. It's crazy not to do High Spirits.
All the songs down for me from beginning to end.
Well, let's see. The first song starts out from one of her great albums called Miss Tammy Grimmes, and she sings Rose of Washington Square.
She said, I'm Rose of Washington Square. I'm with the ring there. Then, baby, basement air, I'm fading poles. With or without my clothes, they say my Roman nose, it seems to please artistic people.
And she does her own version of Ring Them Bells, like nobody's business.
Gather around, I got a story to tell about a Manhattan lady that I know very well. She lives at 5 Riverside, her name is Shirley DeVoe, and she traveled around the world to find a guy next door. Well, there was trouble inside apartment 29E, cause Shirley's mother and father were upset as can be. They said, we hate to complain, dear, we don't like to grouse, but you're nearly 32, you should get out of the house. You gotta ring them bells, you gotta ring them bells, you gotta make them sing and really ring them bells. It's such a happy thing to hear them ting-a-ling. You gotta ring them bells.
A song by Oscar Brown Jr. called The Snake that is an incredible jazz riff.
On her way to work one morning down the path alongside the lake, a tender-hearted woman saw a poor half-frozen snake. His pretty colored skin had been all frosted with the dew. She said, poor thing, I'll take you in and I'll take care of you. Take me in, tender woman, take me in for heaven's sake. Take me in, tender woman, sighed the snake.
And Jimmy Buffett's song called He Went to Paris.
He went to Paris looking for answers to questions that bothered him so. He was impressive, young and aggressive, changing the world on his own. But the soft summer breezes, the French wines and cheeses put his ambitions at bay. Summers and winters scattered like splinters, and 5 or 6 years slipped away.
We know you from Ruthless. I covered that off Broadway years ago.
I was the original Sylvia St. Croix in Ruthless, and the little girl who I was the agent of in that show, who I wanted to push into being a Broadway leading lady, is right now in the midst of her preview period for a show called Legally Blonde. She has a 5-story billboard in Times Square. Her name is Laura Bell Bundy, and
as she played the bad seed.
She played the bad seed, and every night I sang to her a song that said, "You deserve it all. You got talent. Life can be a ball if you've got talent." And that's what I have to say to her now. You deserve it all. You got talent.
What about Natalie Portman? She was in that show, too.
Natalie Portman was, and actually, she wasn't in the show. She, a little girl named Natalie Herslag, was in that show. And she was a brown-haired girl with big brown eyes. And when we watched her rehearse, we would go, she's really not happy. I mean, she was so shy, and she was... So she changed her name about a year after the show closed to Portman, and she sort of proved us wrong. And the other understudy that Laura Bell Bundy had was a little blonde girl, a little spitfire, lots of energy, pitch problems. Her name was Brittany Spears, and she actually did fairly well too. And she's had some hair problems lately, but other than that, she's doing just fine.
Lady Cassano joins us here at the Met Room. How are you?
Oh my God, it scared me. You scared me.
I didn't mean to scare you.
No, I'm sorry, it's absolutely fantastic.
Eli Wallach. How are you, Barry Z?
How are you, Barry Z?
What'd you think of Tammy Grimes' performance tonight?
I'm still shaking. She was wonderful. She is wonderful. She's come here every night and sing, and then come uptown. I'll get you.
Have you ever performed with Tammy Grimes?
I'll tell you something interesting. You sang the song from Mademoiselle Cologne.
That's right.
I did it with Julie Harris. I played the husband.
So what did you think of Tammy Grimes' performance
tonight? She was brilliant. She moved me to my deepest place in me. She's so vulnerable and so magnificent and riveting, actually, you know, mesmerizing. So, and it's great to see you.
Have you ever performed with Tammy Grimes?
No, I haven't. I haven't had the privilege.
When can we see you performing?
Well, I'll be at Hofstra University, but I'm not going to be singing in town. I'll have a couple of movies coming out. I'm in a film with Adam Sandler. It'll be out in July, and I'm on King of Queens, and I've been doing a lot of acting.
My favorite Lanny Kazan's movies are, of course, what's that beach thing you did with Bette Midler?
Beaches.
Beaches? And my favorite Jew.
Oh, thank you. You didn't like my Big Fat Greek Wedding?
Oh, I love that.
Okay.
Come on. We got to get back to the theater right now. There's a Hollywood talent scout wants to see your act.
Is this your idea of a sick joke?
No, honey. He caught the midnight show last night. He was crazy about you, and he's looking for a kid to star in his new movie. Let's go!
Well, don't just sit there. Come on. This is my break into the big
time. Yeah, and how many times do I have to tell you don't wear that costume on the beach? I am not made of money, you know.
Get off my back, Fiona.
Oh, my God. I'm dying from heat prostration. I can't breathe. What are you, a camel or something? Come on, skedaddle. I gotta have a sip.
Before your beloved father passed away and eventually died, he said to me, Belle, after I go, get someone to be with, someone nice.
A pal.
So you went out and found a Filipino bantamweight named Rookie Karoka?
Rookie Karoka, who held the title for well over 6 months.
Until Manny Serpa turned him into guava jelly at the garden?
Serpa butted him.
I'll fight Serpa today and take him apart.
Do you hear what you started here?
I'll see you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.
Okay. Oh, boy. Didn't I say it's a mistake to educate women? But nobody listened to me. Now we have a boyfriend in the house. Is he nice? Greek boy? Oh, no, no Greek. No Greek, a Xeno. A Xeno with the big, long hairs on top of his head.
Costa.
Miss Tammy Grimes, right?
Yes.
I heard the show is really supposed to be called...
Talk so loud.
Oh, I'm sorry.
You shut up.
I'm sorry. I got carried away yelling and screaming watching your show.
Joel was talking so loud.
I know, but I was screaming and yelling watching you perform on stage tonight.
Yeah! 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 Yeah!
Unbelievable. What a show. It should be on Broadway where it belongs.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. But I like it right here.
Is it called Miss Tammy Grimes, the show?
Yes.
Why?
Because that's what my name is.
You're right. You're right. You're right. You're right.
What did you think, Barry? Exactly. What am I supposed to call it? Elaine May?
Touche. Anyway, I have a question for you. Can you tell us the songs you sang in tonight's show?
No.
Please. I beg you.
But for our audience viewers...
I have this dance. I don't know who wrote it, but I'm going to find out by next Thursday.
Can I have this dance for the rest of my life? Will you be my partner every night? When we're together, it feels so right. Can I have this dance for the rest of my life?
I did a song by Tom Waits called Martha.
Operator number, please. It's been so many years. He remembers my old voice while I fight the tears. Hello, hello there, this is Martha. Is this old Tom Frost? Now I'm calling long distance. Don't worry about the cost. It's been 40 years or so now, Thomas, please recall. Meet me out for coffee, and we'll talk about it all.
What are your most famous plays on Broadway that you were in?
You'll have to get my bio, Barry.
As far as films go, you were in so many, including Can't Stop the Music.
I can't think of all of them now. It's my life.
This is Sydney Chatting, a semi-legend in her own time. Sydney, this is ridiculous.
For once, we are in agreement. Hello, boys.
Sydney, you have arrived here like the Wicked Witch of the West.
And you've turned into Snow White. And here are the seven dwarves. Sleepy, sneezy, grumpy, and gorgeous.
Is it true you were supposed to be Samantha Stevens and Bewitched?
Yes, that's true.
What happened?
I decided I didn't want to do it.
Samantha!
My wife's out there!
You bewitched us tonight here at the Metropolitan Room.
Thank you, Barry Z.
Love you, Tammy Grimmes.
Thank you.